Hi friends, this is Amir Hussain and you are watching Trick I Know YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to show you how to build a 7th generation high-end PC for gaming and video editing purpose. I ordered all my products from Amazon.com and assembled my PC at my home. You can also do it. Just follow my steps and you will be able to assemble a 7th generation PC at your home.
So keep watching my video, and if you're not my subscriber yet, subscribe to my YouTube channel for tech tips.
I have chosen Intel i7-7700K processor and a Cooler Master Hyper 212 LED fan for it. Asus Maximus Hero 9 motherboard. Corsair Vengeance LED RAM 32GB. WD500GB SSD. And 4TB surveillance hard drive. Asus ROG Series GTX 1060 graphic card. A 750W SMPS. Cooler Master Storm Stryker gaming case. LG 24-inch Infinity Display Monitor. Order these products from the link given below in description. Boom! Let's get started. Starting with my case. First, you have to open all windows of your case. Ooh, I got the power of a Spider-Man. Here are lots of wire. Lots of wire means lots of confusion. But don't worry. Pull this wire from the back. Some of the wire are connected with our front fan. Leave that. Now time to install our motherboard. To know how to install processor and CPU cooler, please watch my previous video. Now you have to fit your motherboard panel. I got a pretty nice panel. Fit it like this. Now take out your screw given with your gaming case. Use these screws to mount your motherboard. Tight each screw in the case like this. And double tight with a plier. Now I am inserting my motherboard. Insert like this and give some push from the side to fit accurately. Now use these tiny screws to tighten your motherboard like this. Time to install your power supply. Keep it tight. Now these are the power connectors. You have to send these to the back like this. Now do same with the fan connectors. We have two fans. Now here we are. These are the 8-pin extension wires. Select the CPU one and pass it with this hole. Now connect your CPU connector to your motherboard. Now this is our 24-pin connector. This will also connect to a motherboard. Now here I have a front panel connector given with motherboard. Now connect all front panel wires as written. Now pass it to the front. Connect to your front panel socket. Now it's time to open our SATA and PATA connectors. Find some PATA cables. These are our PATA cables. Send it to back. Now connect the front panel fan connector to it. and the other fan connector also. This is our upper fan connector. Connect it also. Now these are our front panel audio and USB 3 connectors. Send them to front. Connect your audio port to the audio socket. USB to USB. And here is our USB 3.0 socket. Plug the connector. Now it will look like this. Here is my WD4TB hard drive and 500GB SSD. Time to arm my hard drive with this bracket. My hard drive is armed and ready to connect. Here we go. Now gently push it to lock it. Insert your SSD here. Tight it with a screw. Now connect your SATA connector to your SSD and another SATA connector to your hard drive. Now take out your SATA cables given with the motherboard. Connect like this, one end to the motherboard and second end to SSD. Do same for the hard drive also. Now here is my big graphic card. Asus ROG, Strix, Nvidia, Geforce, GTX 1060. Looking so fancy and attractive. Time to connect it. Open the second connector for it. And third one also. Just insert your graphic card like this. Give some push to fit it. Now tight it with a screw. Make sure to tight the both screws to give some strength. Now get a 8-pin PCIe connector from the back and pass it through this window. And plug it into your graphic card like this. Now tie the extra wires like this. And also do same thing in the back. Now close the back window. Now our beast PC is ready to on. It's full of RGB lightings, which provides me a great look for my PC. My graphic card is looking so awesome. Looking so fancy in the dark. This is the right way to impress your schoolmates and Facebook friends. Now you can proudly say that you are a pro gamer and an advanced PC user. Now take a look from the top. From every corner, it's looking very attractive and dashing. Woo! Now our PC is ready. It's ready for gaming and video editing. Now come to my PC. It's time to check out gaming performance. I have installed these games to test. Now I am playing GTA 5. The daddy of all the games. Let me show you my graphic settings. These are my graphic settings. Everything is at maximum. Almost all thing is at maximum. The game is running so smoothly, very fast. Enjoying it, no lagging at all. GTA 5 is the best game to test this PC. Now let me show you the benchmark test for this game. I am getting a very high performance with my PC. I am getting average 40 frames per second. That is very good. Hey, I'm a gangster, baby. Boo. Now playing Rise of the Tomb Raider. Here you can see my all setting is at maximum. Now starting the benchmark. It's very cold, guys. Let me skip this. Wow. It's called a place. I will go there. Now the overall score of Tomb Raider is 34 frames per second. Good, good, good. Now guys, playing Batman Arkham Knight, my favorite game. It's running also very fast and very smooth. Without any lagging. I'm very happy, guys, after assembling this PC. Now going to perform a PC performance test. Here we are. My current frame rate is 59 frames per second. Let me skip this because it's too long. Now here is our Batman. What he is doing? My frame rate is still 59 frames per second. This is very high graphics game. That's why it's taking 60 frames per second. That's all, guys. Now have a look at video editing. Editing my own video. It's watching a live preview of my video. And playing a real-time video. At any point. It's not stopping and lagging. Great performance, guys. I like it very much. Now one more thing. Here you can see the duration of my video is 14 minutes, but while exporting this video, it's showing 8 to 10 minutes estimated time, which is less than the duration of this video. It's rendering at high speed. Our Intel Kaby Lake processors are specially made for video editing, guys. That's why I have brought it, and it's really great for gaming also. Loving it so much. So that was the assembling of my 7th generation high-end PC. Hope you like my video and please subscribe my YouTube channel for more videos like this. Thank you, have a nice day. See you in my next video.